Welcome to Appsstuff Middleware. Hi everyone, my name is Mohammed Yassein. Today we'll continue our series of Java design pattern. We know before about what the meaning of design pattern and why we need to use the design patterns. And we discussed before the different type of design pattern like singleton design pattern, a decorator design pattern, and effective design pattern. Today we have a new problem and we have new design pattern. Today our design pattern is builder pattern. Today we'll discuss about what the meaning of the design pattern or builder pattern, why we need to use the builder pattern, and what the meaning of method chaining. Step by step, we will learn or discuss our problem and how to solve it using builder pattern. Let's start our slides and continue. Builder pattern. What the meaning of Java builder pattern? And why we need to use the Java builder pattern? And what is programmer thinking of? I want to build a Java class that contains a large number of optional parameters. And the class consumer can select only the required parameters when instantiate a new object. Now we have a problem. We have a big class contains a large number of optional parameters. What the meaning of optional parameters? That means the consumer can use all these parameters, or can use the class without parameter, or can use some of these parameters, maybe one or more. If you are a programmer, how you can thinking to solve this problem? Our problem is we have a class contains too many parameters in our constructor, but the consumer needs choose only one or more or all, or use the class without any parameters. How we can solve it? We have a problem in Java class creation. This is a creation error or creation problem. Okay, let's think how to solve it. We can solve this creation case by assign a null in unrequired parameters. If we have many parameters and we don't use it, we can assign a null value inside unrequired parameters. Someone told, I can create multiple constructors with different parameters. This is not good practice. Let's think how to use the builder pattern to solve our problem. Let's think. Let's start to use the Java builder pattern. A builder pattern is used to create an instance of very complex object having telescoping constructor in easiest way. We have a complex object with many parameters and very big or have telescoping constructor. Before that, we have to understand what the meaning of method chaining. Method chaining is used to invoke multiple method on the same object which occurs as a single statement, so that we invoke multiple method as a single object. This is a method chaining. We have multiple methods and we will invoke it like a series, but it will show or see as a single statement. Method chaining is implemented by series of methods that return the reference for a class instance. Let's take this example. If we have a cake store and we prepare the cake depends on the customer desire. Some customer need cake with sugar and cream and chocolate, another one need with lemon and fruit, the third one need only the cream and some food with chocolate. This is different cake depends on the customer desire. This is called method chaining. So that if we prepare the cake for first one, he need to add some milk with white chocolates and fruit. Maybe you can add apple or banana, anything, no problem. And add 10 spoons of sugar. This is the first client need. This is cake ingredients with this attribute or these items. This is called method chaining, multiple methods as a single statement. Another one need cake with lemon and 2 spoon of sugars like this, sugar like this, so that this is called method chaining. Let's take our example. If we need to create a bank account class, this class will contains a long numbers of parameters like nationality, salary, visa number, online banking, loan number. This is not all. This is parameters mandatory. Some parameters mandatory. Another is optional. So that we need to solve or find a best practice to create or instantiate object of account. The first approach is create something like that, bank account ACC equal new bank account, and add all these parameters. But the optional parameter we can add assign null like this with unrequired parameters, but this is not good practice. The another approach, we can create many different signature of constructor as like number only, account number only, another one a number only with a children account, another one with full name, the fourth one like this. This is not good practice. Let's start with building this account bank or bank account with builder better. We have many checklists we have to follow to build the builder better. How we can implement builder better? First, we have to create new class bank account. Sure. Add account attributes to this account bank class, like account number, children account, full name, nationality, all attributes we need to add. Add inner class called builder class. This is inner class, this static inner class. Add same attribute inside the bank account to this is builder class. Then create setter method to set attributes for this is internal class, and return reference to this class. This is to build something called method chaining. Create build method to return a bank account. After prepare all method and choose the return value, then create build method to return a bank account. But we have to make sure that the bank account constructor should be a private to prevent instantiate a class direct. Let's start a real implementation for first. Now we have a bank account. We have many attributes in bank account like this one. We have account number, client name, nationality, email, like this, VIB, online banking, overdraft, visa number. But not all user have visa number, or this is not VIB, or doesn't have loan, so that no loan number. Some parameters is optional, we cannot use it. Okay, in real approach or all approach, so that we have to create setter and getter and create a constructor like this one. Okay, then in bank transaction, if we create a new account or for first user or first client one, so that we have to fill all parameters. But we have a problem, this person doesn't have loan number or children account, is no opening balance. If we need to create another account, like this one, so that sometimes we need to add this parameter, and this is optional. This is not good practice. The another way to create multi constructor or different signature for constructor, maybe I can create new constructor with only this parameter like this, and this is not good practice. Let's apply the builder better. First of all, we have to clean all this setter and getter. We don't need this one. Only we have our attribute for bank account. Then we will create a constructor for this one. Bank account constructor should be private, okay? Should be private to prevent instantiate any object direct from this bank account. The third point is create a public static class called builder class, like this. And we need to copy these all parameters inside. This is inner class, like this one. Okay, then we can make something like inner or something like that, inner account number. Now we have inner class inside the bank account. We have something called account builder. This is static inner class inside this class, and we copy the same attribute. Now we need to create a setter for this attribute, because this create account is still private, so that we cannot instantiate direct. Right click and create a setter and getter. We need only to create a setter only. Okay, we create all setter for this class, but we have to make attention, this object will return account builder, will return the same reference for inner class like this, and this will return this. Okay, the same here will return this. Now we apply the same approach for all setter. This all setter will return reference for current class like this one. Why? This is to apply what we mentioned before. This is method chaining, because we will assign value for account number, then return current reference for current object. And if we need to choose another one, set email, so that we will set email and return account object, so that this is to create a chaining method. We finished? No, we have the last thing we have to do, that create a builder public account or bank account build account. This will create a bank account equal new bank account. Okay, we finished? No, we will assign. Now we create instance from bank account. Now we need to assign value for this all bank account from current inner class. After assign value, then we need to assign value for outer class. Bank account dot set dot account number equal this dot account number, inner dot account number, and we'll apply for all, then we'll return bank account. Now we have a build or build account, or we can rename it to build. This build will assign the account bank account attribute with the inner class attribute. Okay, let's review what we did. Now we did many things. First of all, we create a bank account with many attribute or long number of attributes. We make the or made the account constructor is private. Then we create an inner class, this inner class static, to use it direct. Then create the same attribute inside this inner class and create a method or set method. This the set method return an instance or reference for inner class to return or to apply the method chaining. Then create a builder account to return account bank. Now let's try to use or apply our builder better. Let's assume we have new client bank account called client one, client one equal new bank account. Dot bank account dot build the account. This is inner class. Dot set account number. Let's say this is account number for this customer or this client. Dot set loan number. If we have a loan number, and then we can build loan number string. This is loan number. Then dot build. Now we build the first account. Let's have another account, bank account client two equal new bank account dot account number builder to build new set account number. This account number for this client is this number, and dot set his children or set his email like this email, like Yassein at appsstuff.com. Then we can build another thing like his mobile number. This is his mobile number. Then we can build. Okay, what we did now, we use the builder pattern to build different account with different attribute like this, using something called method chaining. Method chaining, as we mentioned before, method chaining is use multiple method like series or like chain, then it's occur like one statement. I think it's very, very easy to use and apply the builder pattern. I hope you get all benefit today. Please try to contact me on LinkedIn, YouTube. Thank for watching me, and goodbye.